Hey guys, how's everyone doing? It's 9:03. I'm sorry I'm late. Been trying to find DJ Bravo. He is so far away. Not sure if he's gonna join us, but guess what? You have me, and maybe somebody special might join us. But to do that, we have to play the special music for him to come in. How's everybody doing? Maybe he is coming. I don't know. I just got a message from him. Don't know. I think there might have been a timing thing because he is very, very far away. So it's a via, via, via. Yeah, I did. I said it was Bravo. DJ Bravo. Dwayne Bravo. Yeah. Woohoo! I have no idea. Let's see. But until then, let me turn the AC on. It's so hot. Hey everybody. How's it going? Should I start this one? Oh shit. Hey everyone. Okay, so here we are. I don't know what day it is of lockdown, nor do I like lockdown. And now lockdown is extended. This is my 1 minute of trash talking coronavirus, and how upsetting it is that we are yet again okay, I'm going to try and get this to work. Not sure. I am in, you guys. I'm stuck in the house just like you guys. It is. How is your skin color the same color on lockdown? I don't know what that means, darling. My skin color is always the same color. Do you mean, is it supposed to be a different color? What a silly question. You know, I think what happens is maybe people use the wrong foundation color, so then you don't really know what's happening. So that might be why you're asking me that question. I have no idea. Let's see, where are you? There you are. Could it be? Or have we evaded disaster? Yay!
Hello.
Is it good morning?
It's 11:40. Yeah,
Oh, morning.
11:40.
Well,
Good
good
morning.
morning. How are
All right.
you?
I'm good. How about you? Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too. Where are you in the world?
I'm home in Trinidad.
Oh, that's nice. And you've been there this whole lockdown?
Yeah. I was lucky to escape. As soon as they call off the IPL, I get on a flight from London and I come back home
Oh, that's
before they
good.
close off the borders. So yeah.
Yeah, well, I guess it's better to be locked up at home than locked up abroad. How
Definitely.
are you? How's your family?
Everyone is good. Everyone is fine. Thank you. How is your family?
Everybody's good and sleeping, thank the Lord.
Okay, the kids are good. Good.
Yeah, they're good. They're all sleeping. And
Oh.
What is lockdown like over there? Are you allowed to go out? What's the situation like?
It's you can only go out if you like go into the supermarket or something like that. You know, but it's not a curfew, but still you have to be inside as much as possible because there's a lot of cops on the road.
Okay, so it's like India.
Yeah, it's similar. But I go and see my kids back and forth. I go and see my kids.
Okay, well, that's good. At least you're able to see the children and be with them.
Yeah.
I want to do 1 minute of trash talking coronavirus and how much you hate it.
Yeah, okay. No problem. Sure.
So why do you hate it so much? Everybody has a different reason.
My main reason is, you know, it take away jobs and lives from you know, it take away lives and it take away jobs from everyone.
Yeah, that is tough. And then did you stock up on anything? Did you panic buy? Did you stock up on things that you love in case it ran out?
I stock up on juice and kiss cake. I love kiss cake and I love chocolate. So I stuck up on that, and but my dad is my cook, so my dad come and cook for me, so he will get all the food stuff that he requires to cook. But for me personally, I love chocolate and kiss cakes, so I stuck up on that.
Nice. And someone told me that you're gonna start training soon.
I start already.
Oh, okay.
I do a lot of I train every day. I try to run a little bit. Do some house exercise, some home exercise. That's it. But
I run too.
You run outside or indoors?
Around my building. I don't leave my building. And I do it pushing a stroller. That's my running. It's not. Wow. It's not that glamorous. And I want to know what's the first thing you're going to do when lockdown is over? What do you want to do?
I think depending on the month, when it's over, I have one son in Atlanta who I haven't seen him since. So the moment I'm able to fly again, I think that's the first thing I'm going to do. I'm going to fly and see my son.
Oh, that's so nice. And what's the weather like right now? Is it beautiful?
Always beautiful in Trinidad. Very hot.
Yeah,
you and your husband have to visit one day, okay?
Yeah, I know a lot of people from there, or I've known a lot of people in my life from there, and so is Daniel. So maybe we will come there. I want to know, what's the weirdest compliment you ever gotten from the ladies?
From the ladies? No, the ladies always give me good compliments.
But what's... What's the funniest?
They said I have nice lips. They love my lips.
And then, is there one that was super funny that said something so crazy?
No, I never get a crazy one. No.
I get never crazy experienced.
You?
Yeah, these people say the weird. You know, they get so nervous and scared that communication stops working. Their communication skills turn horrible.
Oh.
Yeah. They just don't know what to say. One guy started hyperventilating in front of me, and wow. He's like was having breathing issues.
Wow, that's
it
crazy.
Wasn't funny. I had to be like, "Are you okay?" But yeah, it was funny. One girl started crying, like hysterically crying in front of me, and she couldn't stop the tears, and we had no idea what to do. So then we started singing her happy birthday because that's the first song that came to our head. So the entire room of people were singing her happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
But it wasn't
even her birthday? No?
No, she just was crying so much. Yeah. We didn't know what to do.
Oh, okay. She's starstruck.
Yeah. Is there anything that's super funny that's happened on the field when you're playing?
On the field. What's funny? I
Like,
remember.
do you guys do trash talking when you're on the field?
Yeah, the opposition, yeah. We trash
Because
talk, yeah.
I know in basketball there's a lot of trash talking that happens.
Yeah, in cricket they have some as well, but that's an individual thing. Depend on the individual. So like for me personally, I don't trash talk unless it's like
Hello?
me. I will give talks, but only because I know I have that professional relationship with them. But I don't trash talk like that.
Yeah. No, I mean like it's funny trash talking because you guys know each other.
Yeah. Definitely.
I want to know, do you have any talents? Like funny talents or something, and then I will copy you or try to copy you.
I'm a prankster. I like making
You
pranks on
are?
people. I like scaring people.
What's the last prank you did? Daniel's not listening. I'll pull it on him tomorrow.
The last one I did was my daughter mom. She came to my house to drop off some bread because she made some bread. So when she came in the kitchen, I hide behind the doors, and as soon as she rest the bread and she turn around, she just see this guy here saying like, "Where are you going?" And she started screaming. I even posted up on my Instagram, and everyone is laughing at her.
Oh my
So
God.
I enjoy scaring people. I scare my dad, I scare my daughter, I scare everyone who comes to my house.
I have a really funny prank that I want to play on my family, and you might be able to do the same. Hopefully they're not listening. Is you get a banana
Yeah.
and you cut it open, you scoop out the banana and you put those fake spiders inside.
Oh my God, yeah.
And then you close it with glue.
Yeah.
And
Wow.
then you have to do it to your kid because only a child is going to eat a banana when you say, "Here, eat the banana."
Yes. They got a fruit out.
It's really funny. There's this really funny mom who plays revenge on her children all the time, and I watch those videos and they are so funny. I'll send you the link. You'll find it hilarious. So she does revenge like day one through day 30. She does revenge things on the children, plays pranks on them. It's very, very funny.
I go try the banana one. I
The
like
bit,
it.
it is so funny. I'll send it to you. And then, okay, when you're not eating chocolate, and now that you started training, are you on like a special diet? What are you doing?
No, I'm not on a special diet. I don't have like a special diet. But I tend not to. I eat very simple, basically. I like my I like meat. I like chicken. I like fish. I love a lot of rice. I eat rice a lot. But nothing over the moon to said, okay, I will eat at a certain time, or I cannot eat this, or I can't eat that. I eat whatever, but I still train.
That's good. I am like that. I do not like being on a diet. I'm like everybody else out there. Never wants to be on a diet. I just heard your song. It's so cool. Do you want to talk about it? How did you come up with it? Where did you shoot it? Did you write it yourself?
The Corona song. I get the idea, like I said, when I was in London and I was on my way to the airport, heading back to to head back to Trinidad, the Corona song. I just said to myself, I should put a song outside there, like an uplifting song. And when I get to Trinidad, I contact my musical team. I get together in the studio, and we all come up with the lyrics of the song and the idea. And I said, let it be a world song that the entire world can relate to this song, because this virus affect everyone across the world. Not only in certain parts of the world, but everywhere, and yeah, that's where we come up with the idea of the whole place shut down. We're not giving up.
That's great. And where did you shoot this?
I shoot a video in my house, actually.
That's what I thought. I'm like, he's so good. He's probably shooting it in his house and not being bad and going outside. You're setting an example. That's good.
Yeah. In my house. In my house, I did it. And the guy did a very good job. And, you know, I was against shooting a music video because if I shoot a music video, I wanted to incorporate a lot of people. But because of the time, it wasn't possible to get people and kids involved. Yeah. And I was like, let me just do it in my house and just put it out.
Yeah, well, it's better that you put it out there and people listen. And it is uplifting and it's really song. I love your hook step move.
Thank you.
It's
Thank
the best. You very much. Is there anything else you're working on, like another song, or are you working on?
I am working on a song called Number 7. It's a special song gonna be designed for MS Dhoni only.
Oh.
So the song I'm gonna write the song based on his career, his achievement, and the love that we all as cricketers and fans have for him. So the title of the song is Number 7.
Oh, that's so nice. Him and his daughter are adorable.
Yeah,
I've seen those videos online and they're so cute.
With them on a motorbike and stuff, riding.
Yeah, and you know, it's nice when you see a good, healthy relationship between a father and child. So it's really cute, especially little girls.
Yes, it is.
What else do I want to ask you? I want to ask you, do you want to do a challenge with me?
Which challenge? Tell me.
It's a dance off. It's a dance off challenge. It's nothing serious. I call it my really bad dancing, funny steps dance off. So it doesn't have to be amazing. This is funny. So I will copy you and you will copy me. It for one song. So you pick your favorite song, which we can play your current song if you want, and you dance on it, and I'm going to copy you, and then I pick a song, and then you copy me.
So I will pick my Corona song, and we'll do the dance, and then you pick whichever song, and I will copy you.
Okay, good. I have a really good one.
So you go in first?
You tell me.
Yeah, you go first.
Okay. I'm really silly. It's just a warning. Here we go. Let's see.
I don't know how I'm going to dance with this in my hand. I have to get...
You find a good spot.
Yes.
You know... I am really into 80s music. So, are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay.
I have to hear the song.
It won't be too long. I won't torture you.
Which song we dance into? Let me hear.
Maniac from Flashdance.
Okay. Yeah.
Here we go.
Lucky will come feel the beat of my heart. She came home and into life. She has danced into the danger zone. When that dancer becomes a dance. You can catch your light at night. If the skip becomes a fire. All the while between will and what will be. She's a maniac, maniac on the floor. Dances like she's never danced before. She's a maniac, maniac on the
That was good.
Said more and more.
Wow.
I know. But, you know, I reserve all these dance moves just for Instagram.
That's good. First time I ever danced that song in my life. Actually.
You haven't heard this song?
I know the song, but I never danced it. I heard it.
Oh yeah, because you know.
You'll play my song now.
Yes, let's play your song.
Let's go. It's a sad situation. It's a sad situation. It's a sad situation. Don't hold me in your hand, please. All the money will be on the ocean bus. Airport, everything locked up. No one's here coming at Vegas. I'm the victim, carefully hold fast. One time less than Ebola. Love will come back with Corona. This thing feels worse than cancer. Lock us in, I have no answer. This thing is a big disaster. Long time to come to Dennis. That's it.
Guys, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you.
Somebody has, I think, a funny question for you. I gotta funny hold question. On. Okay. Yeah, maybe.
Apoosh, and he played for Tapoosh's Dhaka Bangladesh team.
Do you know someone named Tapoosh? From Bangladesh?
Tapoosh, yeah.
Oh, okay. He says hello.
I started recording a song. I saw your husband was working with him in music.
Yes. He's a great musician.
Very good.
So, Tapoosh wants you to say hi if you can.
Oh, hi, Tapoosh, DJ Bravo.
Sorry, that's the first and only time that's happening. Somebody's having a fan moment out there.
yes, I remember him.
And you guys did a song together, right?
Yeah, it's called Balabashi.
Balabashi.
Balabashi, 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 yeah. Balabashi, Balabashi. Basically saying Bangladesh, we love you, or whatever. We never get to finish that song because I never went back to Bangladesh since, but it's there, it started.
Oh, that's nice. And then once this is over, you guys can finish it.
Yeah, we can definitely finish it, yes.
Yeah. It's a really, really good friend of ours as well, so, and Daniel as well. So he was super excited.
I saw your husband was in studio with him from his page. Yeah. And I was like, wow, yeah, I know that guy, yes.
Nice. Yeah, it's amazing. He works with some of the greatest musicians and artists all over the world. So
yeah.
I was really surprised and happy when I got to hear some of his music.
Yeah. Okay. Nice. Yes, he's one of the best, definitely.
Yeah. Well, I want to thank you so much for joining me today and making so many people out there smile and, we got to hear your song, so that's amazing. And thank you so much for joining me from very, very far away. The next time you get to the beach, please take a beach photo and make us all jealous.
Okay, definitely.
All right.
Take care. Bye.
All right. Bye. Thank you. All right, guys. That was DJ Bravo, and that was his new song, the Corona song, which he wrote, which is very nice. You guys should check it out, listen to it, and let's retweet and support it because we all need a little bit of positivity in our lives, a little bit of music and love. So thank you again, DJ Bravo, and I will see you on TV, and you guys will see me later. Bye, guys.